going to school and got invited to go to high level and talk to the little ones, well, all the different classes, how we went to, what kind of, like a school that we went to when we started school. And it was nice to talk to the kids, to tell them that how I started school and how important education is nowadays, you know, because them days when I started school, I couldn't speak a word of English. So I went to school for 4 years, and then I left school. My language was Cree. Okay. Yeah, it's Cree, and then that's all the language we knew. I couldn't speak a word of English. I didn't know yes or no when I started school, and I came to move to, we were out of town, and we moved into town, and then we had to start school because we were getting family allowance then. So we went to school, and we go home for lunch. If we had something to eat there, that is. and then we go back, yes. Went to school, I couldn't understand the teacher. Nor the teachers couldn't understand me because I was speaking Cree. And it was a bad experience. I never liked that part. But I mean, it took a little while before I was able to say a few words in English. And then from there, you learn from the kids. Other kids teach you, you know, like, you know, so... that's how I went from there. And that's why I have a hard time speaking English now, because I still think that when I speak English, people will laugh at me, you know. So I'm always a little bit shy to speak English. Well, actually, the little kids didn't ask too many questions. They just asked me what grade I went to, I think, and then what kind of school I went to, and what I had for a teacher, and what we did in school, and that was it, mostly. I just told them that I had a bad experience because I couldn't speak English, and that I had to. And I was already coming 9 years old, so it was. But I picked up English, and another thing that the kids, they asked me, I play a little bit of music. I play fiddle. So I play fiddle for these kids. Every class I go to them, and they ask me questions, and then ask me how long I've been playing the violin, or how old when I was started. And so I play fiddle for them, and they enjoy that. They even dance. So I think mostly to talk about education is so important nowadays. It's very, very important. Because as people nowadays, if we have to make a living off the land, we couldn't do it. We cannot make it, because we have to be educated to be able to get good jobs, and that's only life nowadays. Otherwise, it's nothing for the people. Like they have to go to school, and they have to learn, and then they can get a job. And once you get the education, you got it made. You know, then you can find a job. Then you know you can keep on going to school, and finally you can tell the. What I was going to say was, you know, once you get that education and you keep going to school, then finally know what you want to do with your life, then you go from there. It would probably help them, because they kind of, if they understand what I was trying to say to them, they probably would have an idea what could be done. And what you can do anything in this life if you have a chance to do it. You can do anything you want to be. With education especially, so if the kids want to, like, they love music, if they want to play fiddle, it's there. They can learn it. Now it's, and myself, we just had no entertainment, no new TV them days, so we just learned to play music, play fiddle. And I think it helped the kids. No, they had a place set up in the gym, but first we went there, they set up lunch for us, they gave us lunch, and then they tell us to go what class will come to our, in the gym, what class was going to be there first. And then we start from the little ones and then go up to higher grades. I think I had about 3-4 classes there. You know, like come, take turns coming. And then in the end, they all get together and they dance around there. So,
it is. Because of the music that you were
playing. The music I gave them, they enjoyed that very much. And they asked me, how long have you been playing? When did you start playing? I said, I started playing when I was 8 years old, I said. And so I play whatever they want to hear.
So you were self-taught?
Yes. Yeah. By ear, yeah. They're willing to listen to what we have to say. They want to keep listening. they really thank me very much for coming out and be able to talk to the kids a little bit. I didn't talk as much as my wife did, but she, I did mostly the fiddling and tell them what education is all about. I feel quite comfortable because I'm telling the truth. When you're telling the truth, it's easy to speak out. Well, I just think we hit that part a little bit about education is most important. Like, we can't keep on living the way we used to live off the land, and we can't do that. I think it's mostly we have to go the way the white man teaching us to do it now. Mm-hmm. But we can still stay with our culture and stuff and hunt if we get a chance. But now we're not even hunting hardly because we don't have a place to hunt because the land is all taken up pretty much in our area anyway. To me, I can't see it because I don't know what good it's going to do anybody because we're not going to ever use it.
No.
Even if we go through it, I don't see how we could use that. And what's the use to train people in our way when we have to live in the different style of life? Like we can't hunt, we can't trap. And that's our life, to trap and have to move around. That was our life. But now we can't do that. Mm-hmm. We have to stay in one place and stay there and live like the way the other people live. Keep going to school and make yourself something out of yourself. That's the only way now. Otherwise, we got other people coming into our land and taking over, and we're left with nothing. And we can't hunt. How are we going to live here? Mm-hmm. Education is the most important thing in our time here now, and to go forward with it. I can't see any other way. It's easy now for kids because the kids already have lots of experience. They can speak English from the time they're born. And I had 8 children, and I did not want them to speak Cree because we couldn't speak Cree. You know, had such a tough time trying to speak Cree with, I mean English, not Cree, but from Cree to English to change that. Mm-hmm. And actually, English is very easy to learn, but that's why I never taught my kids to speak Cree. Mm-hmm. And I'm kind of sorry now because they should be able to speak Cree. Mm-hmm. That language, I think, is all right because people can still talk the language. You know, I mean, nothing wrong. I don't see anything wrong with that. I started out the hard way. I started working. I never trapped in my life. I like to hunt, but I never trapped. I never, because I know trapping was not good. And I see there was not going to be trapping all the time because there's so many people. Where is the animals going to come from to kill off the animals? Mm-hmm. And I didn't like it. I didn't want to do it. So I started working, and I started working when I was coming 15 years old in the sawmill logging camps. And I worked till I was, 1979, I think I was 59 years old or 49 years old, something like that.
Yeah.
And anyway, then that's the only thing I can say that that's how I started out, and that's the only way you can do it, no other way. I can't see it any other way. It would be good if they could see what if I could tell my whole life story, I would, but I haven't got time for that, so it's it's a long road. Like, I want to learn I know how to make moose hides, but I never really into it. But I helped making moose hides and make dry meat, and I can do that. Yet I would like to pass that on. Mm-hmm. You got to know how to cut the meat. You're going to make dry meat. You buy dry meat in the stores. It's not cut right. You can't eat it. It's like chewing rubber. I would like to see more people get into the law and become leaders in the governments and get into that stuff so we can all work together. I think it would be better for our people.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Instead of getting other people from different countries and trying to bring them here and start to run our country.
Mm-hmm.
They say this is our old Canada.
Thank you.
I've never had a chance to play this for the students, but I did play one called Lonesome Indian.
Mm. Oh, okay. Awesome. You want to play a little bit of that?